stressed out and I have no idea what the schedule is for next week.
I got you.
So, lucky for seniors and freshmen, you have no school Wednesday the 13th. But for juniors and sophomores, testing begins at 7:20 and ends at 12:30. But make sure to get a little bit before 7:20 because you want to be ready.
Don't forget, buses are leaving at 12:40 that day. So if you're a car rider, that's fine. But when you get dismissed, just go to your bus, like a normal day. Yeah. Alrighty, folks. So for Thursday the 14th, we have freshmen and juniors testing. Juniors, you're doing work keys. Freshmen, you're hitting that PSAT. That will be going from 7:20 to 11:30, but you're not going home afterwards. You're staying at school, and you're going to do 4 through 6 hours, so it'll be like, kind of like a half day.
And for seniors and sophomores, your school starts at 11:40. So if you ride the bus, it's about 4 hours and 20 minutes later than normal. So calculate that and make your bus.
For Thursday, here's the lunch schedule. Freeze frame.
Tuesday the 19th, Wednesday the 20th, and Thursday the 21st. For juniors, you have MSTEP and only your chem class, so the rest of your classes are completely normal that day.
I don't have a chem class. What do I do?
You'll just be notified of your date, place, and time. And for everybody else, your day is completely normal. Good luck!
First, you're going to type into your search bar, Grand Blanc High School. Make sure you have the high school page, not the district page. Once you get there and click on that link, you're going to scroll down through our homepage until you find the high school daily class schedules. Click on that, and then click on the link right there, and it will take you to this page. And then you want to click on the spring 2022, and then that will take you to this lovely little page right here, and that's all you need.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy Kyle Wahey, and I'm here at GBFV. If you want your video featured on GBFV, make sure you submit it to this link. You might be able to win a cash prize of 2,000 pennies. You know, $20 is $20. You know what I mean? Seniors, super important. We're starting to make the senior video. And if you want to share your memories and your videos and your pictures, make sure you submit it to this link right here. We want to see all the great memories from the last year. Thank you, guys. That's it from GBFB. It's your host, Kyle Hay, signing off.
How to improve your test-taking skills.
Prepare for the morning. Gather all the materials you'll need the night prior to the test. Make sure you have extra pencils and an eraser just in case. Packing everything the night before prevents unwanted stress in the morning.
Sleeping. The most important thing to do the night before a test is to get a good night's rest. Make sure that you go to bed at a decent time so that your body's not tired the next day.
Eat breakfast. Eating the most important meal of the day can help your brain and body stay focused and awake. Foods with a lot of protein in them will be the most effective for your body in the morning.
Relax. Before coming to school, make sure that your mind is clear and that you're not stressed. Doing exercises and stretches beforehand is a great way to ease the mind.
Budget your time. Pace yourself. This test is timed. Only spend a few moments on the easy questions and no more than a minute or two on the harder questions.
Answer the questions you know first. As you go through each section, answer all the questions you know the answers to first. Mark all the questions you don't immediately know the answer to in your turn and answer them later.
Read directions carefully. Study and review the directions for each SAT section before the test. Use your test time for the test and not for reading directions.
I'm a teacher, I'm a mom, I like to spend time with my family. When I'm out of school, I love to read. I love to spend time in my yard, mess around with plants. I love to travel. I didn't think when I went into college that I was gonna be a teacher. I kind of decided halfway through when engineering got a little too, I was in over my head with computer science. I decided that it was the math that I really liked. So I thought, okay, here's a way for me to enjoy mathematics still, but still work with young people. And the things that I've liked about teaching have kind of changed over the years. Like when I started, I really thought that it was about imparting math knowledge. The longer I've taught, the more I've come to find that it's not so much imparting the knowledge. It's more just about providing what kids need, mentoring kids, giving kids the love they need, and helping them to just like to grow into people. It's a pretty cool job. It's cool that it's cyclical, that I get a new group of students every year. I get do-overs every year, basically, right? Where I get to forge new relationships. Dr. Hammond was the principal who was here for the longest time of the years that I've been teaching. She used to see me in the hallway and she'd say, "Hey Leah, how are you doing?" And I would respond to her, "Oh, Mr. Nicholson will love this." I would respond to her, "I'm living the dream," every morning. And that went on for quite a long time. That would just be our thing. She would ask me and I would say, "Living the dream." And finally one day she stopped after I had said "living the dream" and she was like, "I have a question to ask you. I can't tell when you say that you're living the dream if you're being facetious or if you really do think you're living the dream." And I just kind of laughed and I said, "It depends on the day," which it really does in this profession. Some days it's wonderful and I am living the dream. Overall, that's how I feel. And then other days, obviously, it's really hard and you're not exactly living the dream. You kind of wish you had gone to dentistry school instead. Oh my gosh, just that I'm on your side. I want wonderful things for you. If I can get that across, that someone cares about you, somebody loves you, you have something amazing inside of you, right? Whoever you are, you might have some unique talent or gift and I'm on your side and I'm here to try to help you figure out what that is. And maybe it has something to do with math. It probably doesn't. You know, I think sometimes students don't feel like there's an adult on their side, even if there is, but sometimes they perceive that no one's on their side, but I am. And so are the other teachers in this school, and that's what I want them to know.
Years ago, GBTV legend Jared Berger saw if people wanted to end women's suffrage.
So, I don't know if you guys know a lot about women's suffrage, but the definition, the woman's right to vote. Try to see if people actually know what the word means. Would you like to end women's suffrage?
Woman's right to vote?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, it's just women's suffrage, like, you know, like taxes.
Taxes?
Yeah. Like.
So women don't get taxed?
That's not.
End women's suffrage. No, because women should have the right to vote.
That's incorrect. Would you like to end women's suffrage?
Yes. Yes.
You don't want to see women suffer, do you?
No.
Yeah, woman.
Click yes on that.
Click? All right, I clicked it.
In contact with me. Would you like to end women's suffrage? Sign there to end women's suffrage, please.
Bro, sign your name.
We're trying to end women's suffering.
That's like the right to vote, isn't it?
It's suffering.
No, I'm good.
Yes.
All right, can you sign yes?
Yeah.
Do you know what it means?
No, but I think it's for a good cause.
Jack Goley, man of the people. Do you want to end women's suffrage, though?
For what?
Like, just to end it.
No.
Do you know what women's suffrage is? It's their right to vote.
Yes.
No, don't sign it. Who wants to see women suffer?
End women's right to vote?
Girl.
We're doing a survey today. Would you like to end women's suffrage?
Sure.
What are they suffering?
No, look, it says suffrage.
I want them to vote.
You're helping women across America today.
I'm glad.
How does it feel that you're part of this movement?
Amazing.
We won't see you in 2026. End women's suffrage?
What does that even mean?
Yeah.
Yes, man, that's all NTSU is about, you know, ending women's suffrage, man.
I think the Chick-fil-A sauce prices are a little high, so I'd like to end it.
So I got a little question for you guys. So, do you want to end women's suffrage?
Absolutely.
Yeah, of course.
Click yes right here and then sign.
You want to end women's suffrage?
This is a trick question.
It's so straightforward.
No.
Just women's suffrage.
It's
do you want to end
question.
It?
No! Yeah.
Stop asking
Why are we doing this?
Well, you don't want to see women suffer, right?
No, duh.
That works. Thank you so much.
It's a trick question!
We are here to end women's suffrage today.
Thank you.
This guy's got a brain. Join the movement.
No.
You just
trick
took up
question.
You just took up the whole page.
Sure.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. How does it feel that you're ending a woman's right to vote?
Terrible. Can I take my vote?
No, you're good. You're good. Run. Thank you, sir. You just ended a woman's right to vote. How do you feel?
I feel amazing.
Yes, I would.
Without a doubt.
I think so.
We need to shut down the gas prices a little bit. You know, it's getting a little bit too high out here.
I don't even know what this even is, but.
Just sign it.
Yes. I don't know. Y'all must got some type of petition or something that y'all about to send up to Congress or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Would you like to end it too?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
He's good. All right.
Are you proud to be part of this movement?
I am.
And hey, thank you for your service too. Appreciate it. Hey, you know what woman suffrage is though, right?
I do.
What is it?
It's ending their right to vote.
Oh, so you knew what it was?
No, I didn't. He just told me.
So I would like to change what I actually said. We're not ending it. I would like women to vote. Pro women voting.
Do you want to end women's suffrage?
Yes, I do. Wait, is it a trick question?
No. Not. Why would we, a petition making you sign for a trick question? What people would do that? How does it feel that you just ended women's right to vote?
I hit no. I put no.
No, you put yes. You why? He's running. Get him.
What am I doing?
Fridge.
Ending women's suffrage. Yeah, I feel like you're setting me up here.
No, you just don't want women to suffer anymore.
No, but I got to know what suffrage means.
You got to make sure we know what it means.
I was a math teacher. That's a big word.
But yeah, suffrage is math, right?
No, it's not math. I feel like I've played this game before. See, it's the right to vote.
No, that's the right. That's the right are you sure?
It's the right to vote.
So I don't want to take women's right. I want women to be able to vote.
So yeah, but yes.
So I don't want to end. No, I want. I think it's no. I don't want to end it because I want them to be able to vote.
You sure?
Yes.
You got me so confused.
There's that random guy. Hey, we haven't seen you before, right?
Yeah, no. Now may you have a blessed day. You can walk too. Oh, I'm ever think about you. You know that I'm ever gonna lose.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the morning.